Hi, my name is Yogesh Joshi, and today we are at Startup Masterclass, which is being held at IIT Kanpur campus today. This exciting initiative is being organized by IIT Kanpur Alumni Association, and we have with us Mr. Vishwajeet Sinha. You are the founder and CEO for an agri-tech company called Oxen Farm Solutions. Welcome, Mr. Sinha.
Thank you.
So, can you talk a little bit about what Oxen Farm Solution is all about?
Sure. We are an agri-tech company. We focus on farm mechanization, building different kind of agriculture technologies that can benefit a farmer. Our focus is on providing access to advanced farm machinery to the farmer on a pay-per-use model and a tech-enabled format.
Okay.
Right now, we focus on MP, UP, Chhattisgarh, Maharashtra and Odisha. In last 15 months, our traction has been great. We have crossed 20,000 acres and 15,000 farmers. Idea is that now we start to also provide farmers with other services like market linkage. And the main vision of the company is that we want to bring the next generation technologies like AI, computer vision, machine learning to agriculture space.
Okay.
And hence benefit the smallholders and the farmer community.
So can you elaborate slightly further on as to what is the model and how can a farmer help through this partnership?
Sure. Right now, I would say our main focus is on solving the labor scarcity challenge for the farmer. An average farmer today finds it difficult to find labor because the labor wages have shot up after introduction of certain schemes of the government and also urbanization. Where we help him is to reduce that labor cost by giving him an access. So if I'm a wheat farmer, I do not have to buy a 20 lakh rupees combine harvester. I just have to pay as per my acre. So if I'm a 1 acre farmer, I just have to pay 1500 rupees for harvesting of my wheat farm. We provide him with the machinery, with the manpower, diesel maintenance, all the services. The grain is directly delivered to the place where he refers to, which is usually his tractor. By doing this, he is saving at least 50% on the labor cost. If I give you an example of a paddy farmer today in Chhattisgarh, he spends 5,000 rupees on an acre if he is doing it by labor. But if he uses our machine, he does that in only 2,000 rupees an acre. In the next model, what we are also rolling out is that we are making it very easy for the farmer to book such a machine. So in an Ola kind of or Uber kind of format, he can just stand on his farm, tag his farm and can place an order. It will tell you the acreage of the farm and you can place an order for a harvester.
Okay, that's very interesting. So you also spoke about cutting edge technologies like AI and analytics being used.
Right.
Educate or maybe inform farmers about the initiative. Can you talk as to how these technologies are helping?
Sure. So, I would say we live in very exciting times, and I say that because, never in the past so much of satellite imagery was available to us free of cost. Never was smartphone penetration happening so fast in the rural areas, thanks to Jio that has happened. Never was farmer identifiable to a level that he is today because of the JAM initiative that we call Jandan, Aadhaar, mobile solutions. Once you have linked all these three, it has become to transact digitally with the farmer. We are leveraging on all of this by, for example, we do satellite imagery analysis, which helps us to optimize the route of the harvester. So typically on a 1.5 month horizon, we plan where the route, what the route should be for the harvesters. Mobile solutions, we talked about that, through the mobile booking app, we are recording a lot of farm data for the farmer. Idea is doing analysis, applying machine learning to the farm data that we are fetching. We want to also launch new services for the farmer. If we talk about how we are doing this currently, we have launched an app. It's called a Volo app, V-O-L-O, Oxen, if you search on Google Play Store. What that app does is, depending on your location, the crop that you are growing, it shows you videos because, farmers, it's more conducive for the farmers to look at educative videos than reading content. So they, depending on the app and depending on the stage of the crop, you are shown certain videos on pesticide, how to use more efficient pesticides, how to apply urea, how to do some home, how at your home you can prepare good fertilizers, organic fertilizers, those kind of videos. Depending on, again, location, it shows you the prices of the closest mandis around you. You can measure the acreage of your farm then and there. We have also interesting news that we are, have a feed for that, so farmer can look at the local news. So idea is that moving forward, we record all these transactions and help to create a services platform that can provide huge, humongous amount of value for the farmer.
Quite interesting. Since you are today at this exciting initiative which is focused on the startup community, and agri-tech is one area where this sector could contribute in a huge way,
right,
in terms of helping or maybe improvising the lives of our farmer community. So what's your message to this community out there as to let's say if we see your case study, which is highly successful a real use case right, for this community, what's your message here?
I would say we are in a very interesting time, and I say that because agritech is becoming hot. If you look at how industries are transformed, there are three success factors to that. The market has to be ready, the entrepreneur has to be ready, equally important is that the investor has to be ready.
Mm-hmm.
For the first time, not only in India, but I see that happening globally, that the investor is also ready to invest good amount of money into solving these problems, which have problems or opportunities which have existed for long.
Mm-hmm.
Now we can see unicorns being formed. There are companies in China which are valued at $7 billion.
Mm-hmm.
Investors like Tiger Global are investing into those companies, and we see those, that trickling effect also happening in India. So if you look at last 6 months, just in fresh fruits and vegetable supply chain, there have been 400 crore rupees that have gone into VC investments.
Okay.
So the space is becoming more and more excitement. What this translates for the farmer is that, these services, these benefits which he had been waiting for very, very long period of time, for so many different inefficiencies in the systems, are going to be resolved. Tomorrow's farmer is going to be much more happier than today's farmer, because he is going to get the same stuff cheaper, he is getting to improve his yields, he is getting to get a better price for the farmer. And I see startups helping the government, getting, doubling the farmer income per se.
I see. Wonderful. Any 2-3 takeaways or maybe messages for the startup community that they should emulate in terms of working for this agri-tech sector?
Sure. So for the startup community and the young entrepreneurs out there, what I would say is, if you are looking at agri-tech, you have to be more patient. It's not a overnight success kind of a space.
Mm-hmm.
One has to be very patient in this, mm-hmm, at least in the initial phase.
Mm-hmm.
So scalability might take time. Models are going to be very tricky. That's the second thing, that the a lot of time has to be spent on getting the right pilots done and getting the right model done.
Mm-hmm.
The third thing I would like to say for the agri-tech people is that it's very important to understand the context of the business that you are setting up, the context of the model that you are setting up. And when I say context, it has a community context to it and it has a geographical context to it.
Mm-hmm.
Because we may talk about India, but India, in my understanding, is a continent.
Mm-hmm.
You have a Punjab where you find 50 acres of land patches, and you have a West Bengal where you find 0.2 acres, 0.3 acres of land patches. So whatever business is being designed, whatever model is being designed, one has to take into account that, it's not scalable like you do it in the cities.
Mm-hmm.
The scalability has a geographical context and a community context to it.
Okay.
So these are some of the factors that the entrepreneurs have to keep in mind.
Wonderful. I'm sure that the community, watching your, valued inputs will definitely look forward to, work around these and try to work and contribute towards the growth of the agri-tech sector in the country going forward. Thank you so much for talking to us, Mr. Vishwajeet. And